Nehemiah chapter 9. And in the 24th day of this month, the sons of Israel have been gathered together with fasting and with sackcloth and earth on them. And the seed of Israel are separated from all sons of a stranger, and stand and confess concerning their sins and the iniquities of their fathers, and rise up on their station and read in the scroll of the law of their God Yahweh a fourth of the day. And a fourth of the day they are confessing and bowing themselves to their God Yahweh. And there stand up on the ascent of the Levites Jeshua and Bani, Kadmiel, Shebaniah, Bunni, Sherebiah, Bani, Chenani. And they cry with a loud voice to their God Yahweh. And the Levites say, even Jeshua and Kadmiel, Bani, Hashabiah, Sherebiah, Hodijah, Shebaniah, Pethahiah, rise, bless your God Yahweh from age to age. And they bless the name of your glory that is exalted above all blessing and praise. You are he, O Yahweh, yourself. You have made the heavens of the heavens, and all their host, the earth, and all that are on it, the seas, and all that are in them. And you are keeping all of them alive. And the host of the heavens are bowing themselves to you. You are he, O Yahweh God, who fixed on Abraham, and brought him up out from Ur of the Chaldeans, and made his name Abraham, and found his heart steadfast before you, so as to make with him the covenant, to give the land of the Canaanite, the Hittite, the Amorite, and the Perizzite, and the Jebusite, and the Girgashite, to give it to his seed. And you establish your words, for you are righteous, and see the affliction of our fathers in Egypt, and their cry have heard by the Sea of Suph, and give signs and wonders on Pharaoh, and on all his servants, and on all the people of his land. For you have known that they have acted proudly against them, and you make to yourself a name, as at this day, and you have cleaved the sea before them. And they pass over into the midst of the sea on the dry land, and their pursuers you have cast into the depths as a stone into the strong waters. And by a pillar of cloud you have led them by day, and by a pillar of fire by night, to lighten them to the way in which they go. And on Mount Sinai you have come down, even to speak with them from the heavens, and you give to them right judgments and true laws, good statutes and commands. And your holy Sabbath you have made known to them, and commandments and statutes and law you have commanded for them, by the hand of your servant Moses. And bread from the heavens you have given to them for their hunger, and water from a rock have brought out to them for their thirst, and say to them to go in to possess the land that you have lifted up your hand to give them. And they and our fathers have acted proudly and hardened their neck and have not listened to your commands. Indeed, they refused to listen and have not remembered your wonders that you have done with them and hardened their neck and appoint a head to turn back to their service in their rebellion. And you are a God of pardons, gracious and merciful, long-suffering and abundant in kindness, and have not forsaken them. Also, when they have made to themselves a molten calf and say, this is your God that brought you up out of Egypt, and do great despisings, and you, in your abundant mercies, have not forsaken them in the wilderness. The pillar of cloud has not turned aside from off them by day to lead them in the way, and the pillar of fire by night to give light to them and the way in which they should go. And your good spirit you have given to cause them to act wisely. And your manna you have not withheld from their mouth, and water you have given to them for their thirst. And 40 years you have nourished them in a wilderness. They have not lacked, their garments have not worn out, and their feet have not swelled. And you give to them kingdoms and peoples, and apportion them to the corner. And they possess the land of Sihon, and the land of the king of Heshbon, and the land of Og, king of Bashan. And you have multiplied their sons as the stars of the heavens, and bring them into the land that you have said to their fathers to go in to possess. And the sons come in and possess the land, and you humble the inhabitants of the land, the Canaanites, before them, and give them into their land, and their kings, and the peoples of the land, to do with them according to their pleasure. And they capture fortified cities and fat ground, and possess houses full of all good, dug wells, vineyards and olive yards, and fruit trees in abundance. And they eat and are satisfied, and become fat, and delight themselves in your great goodness. And they are disobedient, and rebel against you, and cast your law behind their back, and your prophets they have slain, who testified against them, to bring them back to you. And they do great despisings, and you give them into the hand of their adversaries, and they distress them. And in the time of their distress, they cry to you, and you from the heavens hear. And according to your abundant mercies, give saviors to them, and they save them out of the hand of their adversaries. And when they have rest, they turn back to do evil before you, and you leave them in the hand of their enemies, and they rule over them, and they return and call you. And you hear from the heavens and deliver them many times, according to your mercies, and testify against them to bring them back to your law. And they have acted proudly, and have not listened to your commands, and against your judgments have sinned, which man does and has lived in them. And they give a stubborn shoulder, and have hardened their neck, and have not listened. And you draw over them many years, and testify against them by your spirit, by the hand of your prophets, and they have not given ear. And you give them into the hand of peoples of the lands. And in your abundant mercies you have not made them a consumption, nor have forsaken them. For a God, gracious and merciful, are you. And now, O our God, God the great, the mighty, and the fearful, keeping the covenant and the kindness, do not let all the travail that has found us be little before you, for our kings, for our heads, and for our priests, and for our prophets, and for our fathers, and for all your people, from the days of the kings of Ashur to this day. And you are righteous concerning all that has come on us, for you have done truth, and we have done wickedly. And our kings, our heads, our priests, and our fathers have not done your law, nor attended to your commands and to your testimonies that you have testified against them. And they, in their kingdom, and in your abundant goodness that you have given to them, and in the land, the large and the fat, that you have set before them, have not served you, nor turned back from their evil doings. Behold, we today are servants, and the land that you have given to our fathers, to eat its fruit and its good, behold, we are servants on it, and its increase is multiplying to the kings whom you have set over us in our sins, and over our bodies they are ruling, and over our livestock according to their pleasure, and we are in great distress. And for all this we are making a steadfast covenant and are writing, and over him who is sealed are our heads, our Levites, and our priests.